Okay, let it log in. Okay, you know, when you log in, that when you see there is a designer option is there. In the designer option, you have many options are there: integrations, connections, lookups, packages, agents, adapters, and libraries. But so when you go, just when you click on the integrations, so it will go to the main section, like where you can develop the code and all the things. But before that, when you before you develop the code, you have to create the connections. You need to know what is connection and all the things. Okay, one second, it is logged in. Again, it is asking again. Because the front, from the front end, its view is different. So I would like to show that from the front end, so that after that I'll tell each component, what is a connection, what is integration, what is a package. I can explain that, so you can, yeah. So this is the screen, and you directly click on the integrations. Next time onwards, you don't need to worry about, just save this URL and just directly log in, that's it. Okay, this one I'm talking about. There is integrations, connections, lookups, packages, and agents are there, right? So when you click on the designer, this tab will open, okay? So what is an integrations? Integration, nothing but like, you know, okay, let's say you have a source system, source system is Oracle HCM is there, or maybe let's say talk about Salesforce is there. Source system is Salesforce is there, okay? And the target system is maybe Oracle ERP is the target system, okay? So you have to transfer the data from the Salesforce to Oracle ERP. So when integration is not there, okay, you have to import the data manually, either Excel or maybe you maybe some XYZ options are available, right? You have to do manually, and you have to go to the ERP. I mean, first of all, you have to go to say log into Salesforce, okay? And you have to import the data manually, okay? And after that, again, you have to go to the ERP, okay? And again, you have to export the data based on the options, okay? You have to export the data into the ERP, okay? This is a manual process. Now, our task is everything should be an automation, right? So when you talk about automation, so here we can use anything like Sovai, we can use it, we can use MuleSoft, we can use Oracle Integration Cloud Service. So Oracle Integration Cloud Service, when you talk about Oracle Integration Cloud Service, it is having a predefined adapter, and it is also having good connectivity between the SaaS applications and on-premises applications. Okay, that's the reason we are using the Oracle Integration Cloud. Okay, so in order to make a connectivity between the source system to target system, nothing but Salesforce to Oracle ERP. Okay, first of all, we need to create a connections. After, what is a connection? I'll explain that. So I have to tell X connection details in detail. Okay, but when you're talking about after creating the connections, you have to create a bridge between the source system and target system. That bridge you can develop in the integration layer. Okay, I'm just telling about what is an integration here. Okay, I'm not telling about like how to create integration. I'm not telling about today, but I'll be telling about tomorrow on that. Okay, so integration will create a bridge between the source and target systems. Okay, and the connections, let's say coming to the connections, connections is like, okay, if you wanted to access any system, okay, any system, nothing but like, you know, let's say we have taken one example, right, Salesforce, and another example is Oracle ERP, right? So in order to access the Salesforce or Oracle ERP, you have to create a connections inside the Oracle Integration Cloud. Without having any without having a connection, you cannot access anything, and you cannot interact with external world. Okay, if you wanted to interact with a external world, okay, you need to have a connection for that. Okay, the connection is very important thing in Oracle Integration Cloud. Let's say if you want to access the database, how will you access the database? You have to create a connection for that. Okay, if you want to access your FTP server, you have to create a connection for that. Okay, if you want to access for Oracle HCM Cloud, you have to create a connection for the Oracle HCM. So you're getting right what I'm trying to say for the connection?
That's right.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So I think this screen is looks good, I guess, when compared to that. Okay. Yeah. The monitor connections is nothing but I'll tell about the connection in Dell, but I just given there as a brief description about the connection and integrations. Coming to the dashboard. So dashboard is nothing but after you activate the integration, you developed one integration, okay? Maybe say Salesforce to Oracle ERP, okay? You developed one integration. After that, you activated and you tested it, okay? yeah, maybe it worked or it worked successfully, or maybe it may fail also, right? So those information you can find in the monitor screen. When you go to the monitor screen, you can see the data flow, maybe data transaction flow. You can see the data transaction flow, and even you can download the logs, whatever the logs are there, right? You can download the logs from the monitor section. There are some other sections are there, tracking section and all the things, but I'll be explaining in detail when I'm explaining the monitor section. By going to the monitor section, you can see whether that particular integration is successful or failure. Okay, how many requests has received, at what time it is received, at what time the request has received, okay, and how many hours it has executed or how many minutes it has executed. Everything you can find that, and even you can download the logs. Let's say if you're talking about some traditional thing like, you know, Oracle server or some XYZ technology, you have to go to the some XYZ location to download the log. You have to go to the back Linux machine to download the logs, right? But when you're working with Oracle Integration Cloud, you don't need to go anywhere, and you don't have any background backend access, nothing but accessing a Linux service or something. Okay, you don't have any access for that. Everything can be done over the browser only. Okay. And the lookups, I don't know how to tell here, but the lookups is here. Okay, let's say in the Salesforce, maybe address field, maybe they are using address field as address. I mean, city name. Okay, they are using the city name in the one of the fields. They're using city name. Okay, and if maybe city name, okay, let's talk about South America. Okay. Let's say if we're talking about South America, they're using in Salesforce, they're using South America, okay? But when you're coming to the ERP cloud, when you are integrating the ERP cloud, they're not using the South America. They're using the one of the ID. Maybe they're using the number instead of the name, they're using the number. So using this lookup, you can translate from one value to another value. The source is having a different value and the target requires a different value. So you need some translation, right? So this translation can be done here. I mean, you can maintain some static values here by creating a lookup, okay? And you can refer that lookup in your integration to translate from one value to another value. Let's say example is United Kingdom is there, okay? So maybe the target system is requires either value or maybe short code, maybe. It will be better if I take a short code. Let's say United Kingdom. So ERP cloud wants short code. Okay. So whenever any value is United Kingdom is there, then you have to convert into UK. Okay. Whenever United States of America is there, then you have to convert into US. Okay. Those information you can maintain here in the lookups. Okay. I'll be explaining in detail about the lookups. You don't need to worry about it. So maybe don't think about it in this way, but for understanding purpose, I'm telling that. Let's say you're working on the, everyone knows, right, in the database, right? So in the database, tables are there, right? You can maintain some static values in the table, right? So the same concept here, okay?
Say that again, the last part.
So, you know, database, right? In the database, you have tables, right?
Mm-hmm.
Sometimes you may need to store some data, right? Some static data, and you can use that data in the packages and all the things, right?
Yeah,
that's the same concept.
The EB world, the lookup is like a code and then description.
Yeah, I forgot. You people are from ABS background, right? So in the EBS also, when you're talking about ERP cloud also, internally they're using the lookup concept, right? The same concept here.
Okay.
But we are not using any database here. It's there. Inbuilt functionality is there in the Oracle Integration Cloud. Just you need to click on this lookup section and create a file on that and just add the entries. That's it. Okay.
So there will be two files, one for the source, one for the destination.
That I'll be explaining. Yes. As of now, yes. Answer is yes. But I'll be explaining in detail when I'm explaining about the lookups. Okay. So I'm not explaining much on the lookups now because lookups will take some time, and again, how to use that lookup also I'll be explaining there. Okay, don't worry. Just I'm telling about the features. As of now, I'm telling about the features, and after that, I'll be explaining each part. I'll be explaining in detail with examples. Okay, you don't need to worry about it. Okay, packages. The package is nothing but grouping the same functionality related integrations into single unit. Let's say if you're talking about you're working for the account payables module, okay? for the account payable modules, maybe you may create two or three integrations. Okay, so you wanted to maintain those integration in single unit. So at that time, so we can use packages to group into a single unit. The package is nothing but grouping similar integration to single unit. That's called packages. Okay, and agents nothing but when you're trying to connect on-premises environment from the cloud.
I was trying to make a note of the packages. So what did you say, grouping?
Don't do that, because I'll be explaining clearly when I'm telling about each module clearly. Because when I'm talking about connections, I'll tell about the connection in detail. Okay, when I'm talking about lookups, I'll tell in detail. Because you'll miss something if you're trying to note down. Okay.
Grouping multiple units into a single.
Grouping similar integration. Okay, grouping similar integration to a single unit.
Okay.
Similar integrations. Okay.
Yeah.
Agents. Agents is nothing but Oracle Integration Cloud is nothing but, it's a cloud thing, right? If you wanted to connect to the on-premises environment, okay, non-cloud environment. If you wanted to connect to non-cloud environment, okay, you need to have some firewall setting and all the things, right? So you don't need to worry about the firewall and security related things, okay? Just you need to install the agent on the on-premises environment and connection will open. There is a bridge open between the OIC and the on-premises environment, okay? Agent will be used to open a bridge between the cloud to on-premises environment, okay? And adapters, okay? Adapters nothing but, I'll skip now because I have a very good slide for the adapters. I'll explain that, okay? Library is nothing but JavaScript. Here library is nothing but, JavaScript. Do you guys have any idea about JavaScript, first of all?
Yeah, I have.
It's not Java, it's a JavaScript, okay?
Yeah.
It's a out of the box functionality, okay? Sometimes you need to do sometimes you need to execute something, but OIC, internal, whatever the OIC inbuilt functions are not supporting, And at that time, you can think about JavaScript and you can write something at outside, okay? And you can import that functionality into the OIC and you can call that functionality. That's it. JavaScript, you can write something outside at JavaScript, okay, .js file and import into the ICS, okay? That's the second step. Third step is call that function directly in your integration. That's it, okay? Why it is required? Whatever the inbuilt functions are there, whatever the inbuilt functions which is provided by Oracle, right? So if those functions are not sufficient, in that case, you can think about out-of-box support. Okay.
So outside means what? I didn't get that.
Outside means, okay. Where will you develop the JavaScript? You have to write something.
If I'm working on Oracle, I have Oracle platform. I would create there only, right? Or yeah. You are talking about Unix or something else?
No. There is a notepad, is there, right? In the notepad, write the code manually, okay?
Okay.
Because you don't have any flexibility to write JavaScript from front end, Oracle OIC front end, okay? You have to write outside, nothing but either notepad or notepad++ or textpad, whatever it is. You write it there, okay? And after that, import that functionality into the OIC. That's it.
Okay.
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 And I'll be explaining with one example in coming classes. Okay, you don't need to worry about the JavaScript here. Okay.
Okay.
So if you guys are clear, then we'll talk about connections.
One more question. Do we need to have UI? Do we need to create UI as well when we are working on ICS, or it's just the connection and pulling data from one instance to another?
I didn't understand the question, but I got the context. You're saying that, okay, we don't need to create any UI, okay?
Yeah.
So I think uh, I'm I think explained, I think day before yesterday, I explained one thing, right? You don't need to worry about anything. Just by using the URL, you can log in, okay? Log in and develop the code on the browser.
Okay.
Okay. Like when you're accessing the ERP cloud or maybe BA publisher, whatever it is, right? You are accessing directly on the browser, right? If you're talking about cloud.
Okay.
I'm not sure about the on-premises environment, how it is. Okay. The same way. Just like, you know, I think I have it open, right? Yeah. I have accessed the URL in the browser, right? In the browser, I can create a connections here.
Okay.
Okay, I can create a connection here and I can use it. That's it. And you don't need to create any UI for this. Okay. They have already given the beautiful wizard and the UI and all the things. And just we can use.